Hashtag Ethan here along with Mrs. Starkey.
Howdy, yo!
And we're here to continue going over chapter 11? Is it 11? Or is it 12?
I think it's 12.
12. I have the right page up, but...
Yeah, you know. It doesn't have it, like, on the top. Hang on.
No, it doesn't.
Flipping it through here and I passed it. Yeah, we're in 12.
Okay, chapter 12.
Yeah. We're about halfway through with it.
Mm-hmm. And, yeah, links for all of Mrs. Starkey's stuff are in the description. Buy her art.
Yes, buy my art. My book just, like, closed itself.
Oh,
I had
no.
it open, and it went, froop! And I was like, wow.
It's a ghost.
It must be.
It's a ghost. Like,
you shall not pass.
You shall not pass.
Oh, my goodness. But yes, buy my art, and, you know, my YouTube channel, I still have videos there.
They're very good videos.
Watch my backlog, you know. Eventually I'll get back to it. Still trying to just kind of day-to-day at this point.
Mm-hmm.
And also fulfill my obligations, you know, doing this project with Casey here. I also did a collaboration with Pine Snake.
What?
We read a doozy of a blog.
Oh.
So if you're not subscribed to Pine Snake, you might want to check it out.
Yeah, I'll throw the link in the description.
This is a really... I'm just gonna give you, like, a content warning, because it's really, like, misogynistic, awful Bible stuff that the dude is justifying in this blog.
Yeah.
And we go over it, and we go, oh my god, this is awful, mm-hmm. and explain why, and then we talk about politics, because, you know, we can. And yeah, so check it out. I'm not sure when it's coming out. I just asked them, because I'm obviously on top of things, right? But yeah, I got that going on, and I'm still recovering. My foot feels a lot better. It's not back to normal. I don't think it'll ever be, but I'm
just glad it's better.
Yeah, it's a lot better. Like, I can walk,
right?
You know, without a cane or a boot or anything. So
always a plus.
Yes. It just feels really weird, and sometimes it hurts when I spend too much time walking.
Mm.
So I have to be really careful with that. Anyway, blah blah blah.
And yeah, I just have the same old going on. We're going to be doing an iron infusion, the special kind for kidney and liver failure patients, because that's the only one I'm not anaphylactically allergic to.
Oh,
and we're hoping that's going to help with, like, the weakness and the tiredness and the dizziness.
I hope so, too, because it's been a real struggle.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
this morning, I just kept falling back asleep. I just couldn't stay awake.
Yeah, well, I mean, right now, as weak as you are, and as much as you're, like, suffering through all that, like, sleep, we'll take it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I know it sucks, but at least you're not, like, awake and in pain and dizzy.
True.
And,
yeah.
You know?
Very true.
With a headache or, you know, just, oh, so many things. So, but you'll make it. You'll make it. They'll figure this out.
Always push through. Always keep fighting, as the slogan is.
Day at a time.
But yeah, so speaking of possibly not being enough, we're on the section, If I Were Good Enough.
Oh, it's a doozy.
It was a very heavy exercise to get through, and a lot of contemplation and wishing and hoping.
And praying and thinking and planning. I could not help myself.
Oh.
I probably could. I have absolutely no restraint.
It went in my head, too. Like, I
I'm pretty
of the same thing.
I'm sure the audience, you know, went there, too.
Yeah, I mean, probably.
Assuming that, you know, most of the people in our audience are old enough to
to know that song. Yeah.
Yeah, to get the reference. Oh, man. Anyway. So yeah, this was a doozy. I admit that for like a couple of weeks, I was just like kind of struggling. Okay, not kind of struggling. It towed me up. Okay, as we say, from where I'm from, it towed me up. And, you know, I just kept going over the what might have beens and kind of like grieving. It's a grieving process, right? Of who I could have been.
Right.
What I could have done. A lot of that. And some of the stuff was like stuff I can do. Right? But a lot of it's... We'll go into that. We'll go into it, yeah. I guess, later on.
She says, the next exercise can be very helpful if you spend time on it and think carefully about it. At the top of a page in your journal, you write the heading, If I Were Good Enough, and then write about the things that you would do if you felt good enough right now. If I were good enough, I would... Keep at this until you have written at least 10 things. I'm always surprised when I do this myself, as I find it can change from year to year. It is also a useful way to demonstrate that you have vanquished the old negative internal messages and that they are not controlling your choices any longer. After doing this exercise, read it to someone who loves you and get his or her reaction. Allow your internal mother to digest it as well, and then start doing the things on the list. So, do you want to go over yours?
I suppose so. And let me just figure out. I should have had this. I'm so prepared, y'all. I'm so ready. I'm just ready to jump into this. So, I just put 10. This is about all I could handle at the time, right? If I were good enough, I would finish my education or pursue singing, which...
Oh my god, that was my first on my list.
Really?
Yes.
It really shouldn't shock me. It shouldn't. Because, I mean, we have, first of all, so much in common. And, you know, you have such passion for animals that... You know, I'm sure I shouldn't be surprised at all that you want to continue your education so you could help them. But yeah, and my education was, the goal was to be a counselor to abused children. That was my goal. And I like singing, but man, I'm almost 40. I don't know. And with the education thing, I don't even know where I would go to school. So it's, I don't know. I think that I can fulfill that need to help people who have been abused in other avenues like this, maybe.
Yeah, definitely.
I think that's more achievable at this point than, you know, just going, well, I'm gonna go to school now because I've got some obligations that I have to take care of first and not in the best health. So... yeah. I mean, I can continue my education just on my own. I do. I read books. And keep... I don't know. I keep challenging myself intellectually all the time. When I'm not playing video games. And fulfilling duties as a wife, mother, slash everything else. Cook. So yeah, did you want to go over your first one? Kind of like do a switch?
Sure. It was finish my education and get my veterinary technician license. And I think one thing that kind of goes along with that is had I not let mom influence me, I would have stayed at the college of my dreams, like my number one college. So that was definitely influenced by her. Now the education is just more or less influenced by my health.
Yeah.
And just coping with that. But yeah, I would love to.
Yeah, and it's funny that you say, well, it's not funny at all, but it's just kind of like, wow, you know, our experiences have been so parallel in a way because my mom influenced my education a lot.
Hmm.
She did not pick my majors for me. I did that. She wanted me to do this and that and the other. She wanted me to go in the medical field or teaching or whatever she was doing.
Mm-hmm.
And no. No. I picked what I wanted, but at the same time, she had a really nasty drug habit, and because of that drug habit, she died. And I was still in, I was still going to the university when this happened, and it just sent me into like total depressive state. And by the time I was just kind of snapping out of it, it was a struggle just to survive because I'd had two kids by that point.
Mm-hmm.
And so yeah, that there was a little bit of influence on that too. All right, my second one, number two, would be, if I were good enough, I would be helping the abused cope, whether through therapy or music or some other medium, which, as I said before, I'm kind of doing.
Yeah.
So, yeah, just in a different way.
Mm-hmm.
What's your second one?
Adopt a dog.
Adopt a dog. Oh, hey, that's achievable, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I have to get up to the being able to walk that much per day, because I don't want to get a dog and then never take it out.
Right.
So, but that, yes, that one is achievable.
Awesome, especially if you could get this whole weakness thing figured out. Mm-hmm. That would be like great exercise, getting outside, companion with a dog. That would be lovely.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so another one that's unachievable, in my opinion, at this point. If I were good enough, I would play tennis, baseball, or basketball.
Oh, I love tennis.
Tennis is fun. Oh, my God. Fun. My favorite game is basketball. Loved it, played it, kicked butt at it. But yeah, I health and everything else, I can't.
Mm-hmm.
I was very athletic growing up, and I could have, but my parents worked me like a mule. Like, my dad had me hauling rocks and sand and, you know, all this other stuff for projects that he was doing and never finished. Every time that my mom moved somewhere, I had to haul all of the boxes. I had to do all of the heavy lifting. I had to bring in all of the groceries. So my body is tired.
Yeah.
I have a lot of arthritis and et cetera and so forth, and plus car wreck. That was, I blame her. She allowed a drunk driver to take me somewhere.
Holy shit.
Yeah. And I fractured my my devil's tailbone. And so that bothers me once in a while.
I fractured mine at one point, and when it gets cold sometimes, I'll feel it, and it's like, oh, ow, what?
Yes, and like, I didn't have that many problems when I lived in Texas, but when I moved to Iowa, every year,
the winters,
around this time of year, when it starts getting cold, and when it gets colder, like in December, November, December, sometimes I can't walk, it's so bad.
Mm.
So, yeah, I want my dreams for all that. But, what's your third one?
Kind of similar, but, like, do a full workout at least 3 times a week. Like,
nice.
Cardio and, like, weight training, which also is technically attainable. I don't know. It depends on how my muscles kind of react, but I'm trying to do the treadmill when I feel well enough to do it.
Yeah, that's good.
I am down to 7 minutes now, though, so.
Well, 7 minutes is better than no minutes.
True.
Right? So, and you're going through some really shitty things right now in terms of, you know, the weakness and things. So I think you're doing pretty well for what you're going through.
Well, so thank
give
you.
Give yourself some credit, girl.
I will try.
So number four is actually something that I could probably achieve if I just put the work into it and the thought into it. Author a book or books, whether it be fiction, nonfiction, autobiographical, or whatever. I would like to do that before I die. I think that's something that, like, I feel really drawn to do. And if I don't do it, I feel like I'm failing. You know? And honestly, that puts a lot more pressure on me to do it. But also, the pressure stresses me out and it blocks my ability to write.
Yeah.
So it's like...
Catch 22.
Yeah, kind of like that. What you got?
Get married, which we can't do right now for insurance reasons.
Right.
You know, the reason that most people get married.
Yeah, that's
But yeah, his insurance wouldn't cover the bulk of, like, my prescriptions and everything, so.
So, is this, like, a situation of pre-existing conditions?
Yeah, pre-existing prescriptions. My prescriptions would be just astronomical out-of-pocket. Right now, I am privileged enough to have Medicare and Medicaid and typically only pay, like, up to $3 for a prescription.
Yeah.
But it's literally over $10,000 a month if we pay, like, in full. So that would be and of course it would be less than that, but it would be a significant amount, so.
Oh, that sucks.
Mm-hmm.
don't get me down this rabbit hole of how screwed our insurance
right?
is.
But,
you know, hopefully things will change and you'll be able to do that.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Another one that probably isn't going to happen because I'm me now, you know. If I were good enough, I would run for political office. Now, I have, because as a result of the abuse and the things that I have endured, I've not been, like, if people started digging into my background and everything, like, they would find things like, cussed out her boss, you know, and shit like that. So, I mean, I don't think that that would look good.
I'm sure people have. Like, look at who's in charge right now. Like, and the shit that's in his background.
Yeah, but...
Cussing at your boss rates at about, like, a 0.3 on a scale of 1 to 10.
Like, yeah.
It's not even a 1.
True. I don't know. I don't feel confident enough to... I don't think I could handle the stress because all the
that
trauma.
Too. Yeah.
And, you know, it's just too much. So yeah, what you got?
Well, this one's kind of dumb, but, it just not be disabled anymore. I don't, but, like...
Magic wand!
Right, yeah. If like, wishes were, what is the saying?
Fishes. There's another one, you know, wish in one hand, shit in the other. See which one fills up first.
Yep.
But, I mean, honestly, that's not dumb, though, because that's something that you want. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's okay to grieve that. In fact, I'd say it's important to grieve that. And, so yeah, it's not dumb. It's not dumb. Although, I would say that while it's possible that you can better your health through things that you are doing, you are taking steps toward, you know, being as healthy as you can with the treadmill and, you know, all these different things. And also dealing with all this psychological crap that your mom put you through. I mean, you're doing your best. And I think that counts for something. I think it does.
What's your next one?
well, if I were good enough, I would face each day without that nagging, overcritical voice in my head.
Right? That would be nice.
Yeah, wouldn't it, though? It would.
Mine's just, worry less.
About the same, really. Yeah.
Let go of, like, not worry so much over things that are completely out of my control.
Mm. Now that's really the catalyst to it all, isn't it?
Yeah. It's the key.
Yeah, the key. Alright, if I were good enough, I would not be so suspicious of other people. I would be more trusting.
Mm.
Which, I'm sure if Maddie's watching this, will say, yeah, right. Because I'm often accused of giving too many people the benefit of the doubt.
Mm.
And I do this as kind of a overcompensation for my lack of trust in people. So,
yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm like, it's the once bitten, twice shy thing.
Yeah.
You know, like, you trust the wrong people too many times, and it's like, I don't want to do that anymore.
Yeah. Well, someone once told me that it costs you nothing to be nice, really.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of debunked by this whole thing, right? It does cost you some pain and agony, and a lot of times heartbreak.
Just yeah.
Plain and simple heartbreak. But in the long run, you know, as long as you're treating people like human beings with rights and, you know, as much dignity as they deserve, I guess.
Right.
If they're completely treating you like shit, have at it. To a limit, right? Don't completely lose your cool. But, you know, just setting healthy boundaries and, you know, knowing when a relationship is too toxic and being able to cut someone off if need be,
mm-hmm.
which is difficult, but is necessary sometimes.
Yeah.
That's about the best you can do.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm working on this one. Like, it's a it's a continuous process.
Mm-hmm.
So this is probably going to be on the list for a long time.
Yeah. Definitely. My next one is buy a home in the suburbs with some land and get a horse once I own said home and land.
Ooh. That would be absolutely lovely.
It would be, but I don't see this one really as feasible. Like, the home, sure, but probably not the horse.
Yeah, no horsey. That's a lot of work to take care of a horse. A lot of money, too.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. I don't know, like, it wouldn't be too awful. Like, they have places where you can, ranches and things like that, where you can go and visit the horses and ride them and feed them and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you could do that once in a while,
mm-hmm.
and that would be enjoyable.
Yeah.
And achievable.
Yes. A little bit more achievable.
Yeah. Let's see, where am I at? Oh boy. This one's a doozy. If I were good enough, I would not be so worried about annoying people or being unloved.
Mm. Yeah. That's a good one.
It runs deep.
Mm-hmm.
So.
But yeah, that one hits pretty deep.
Yeah, I can't count the tears.
Mm-hmm.
I just, after writing this and, like, thinking about it, this is really one of the things on the list that just really messed me up for a while.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure how to achieve this either.
Yeah. I mean, I guess, like, combating the negative messages and the, you know, that mother voice in your head. Not the internal mother, but our actual mothers can help with that.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think you are.
My next one is visit more with family and friends. Just because, like, and it actually would be the same as my next one, which is attend more functions. And that's just basically, like, a health thing.
Yeah.
Especially right now.
Yeah, right now, probably not such a good idea. Maybe at least wait until we get a vaccine and people figure out that, hey, masks are a good idea.
Right?
Let me try that out for a while.
Revolutionary.
Oh, God. All right, so my next one is be less prone to manipulation by dangerous people, which ties into the trust thing.
Yeah.
I tend to be drawn toward people that remind me of my mom.
Mm-hmm.
And this is something I'm definitely working on now. And so far it's been a long road, but I think that I'm finally getting somewhere in terms of this, so...
Okay.
It's achievable.
Mm-hmm.
It's been rough, though. A lot of tears, a lot of difficult decisions, you know.
Oh, a lot of hurdles.
I ended up, you know, making friends with people and truly, genuinely loving them, only for them to abuse me in some way. And it just hurts. Hurts really bad.
It really does.
To think about it, because it's not only when it's people that remind you of your abuser as a child, it just compounds the pain in a way that is indescribable, really. It's like sometimes you can put up like this plexiglass or something to that black hole that is your heart, you know? And it seems like whenever these kind of things happen, you get experience another toxic person that reminds you of your parental figure who was also toxic.
Mm-hmm.
It's like they just completely tear down the plexiglass and you're sucked back in again.
Yeah, exactly. And like, because you kept trying and trying as a child, I found that I keep doing that as well as an adult.
Oh yeah. Definitely.
Whereas, like, other people would be like, oh no, they're just a douche, like, don't bother with it. And we're right. Like, no, we can make this work!
Yeah, holding out on, you know, hope that they will understand and try to, like, and I still, like, in the last few instances where this happened, I was still kind of like, look, you know, this is... Let me just lay it all out for you, you know, how you hurt me, why this is toxic, etc., etc., and they do the usual gaslighting thing.
Yep.
And I would say, oh, well, look, you know, if this continues, I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
I've said my piece, I've offered you an olive branch, I've told you what my limits are. And, you know, now that you're not going, it's obvious that you're not going to abide by those. You don't have the respect and love for me to understand that this is hurtful. Then, bye.
Mm-hmm. Pretty much.
Bye, Felicia.
Bye.
Yeah. Door, let the door hit you in the ass, for all I care.
Mm-hmm.
So... My last one, I think, is the most important one. And it is trust my own abilities. So, and that's the hardest one to do on this whole list for me, is trusting my ability to take care of myself, to take care of others, to make the right choices, to not be a complete and utter failure, to not be a stupid idiot, as my parents told me so many times.
Mm-hmm.
Just to... Yeah, like, I know that, as some people say, intellectually I know this.
Right, yeah. Logically.
Kind of a cringe thing for me, and I'm not really sure how it is, but anyway. I know this, but to feel it is a whole different thing. Mm. It's a whole different process. When you feel something, it's automatic. When you know something or when you think something, you're dealing with something that is a time, it takes a long duration of time to assess the feelings, and you know, there's often a battle between what we feel and what we're trying to sort through, you know, what we mm-hmm. know to be true. So yeah, process. And I think honestly this should have been my number one, because everything else on this list, it hinges upon
could be
this.
Helped with that. Yeah,
yeah, it's a prerequisite. Mm-hmm. This right here. If I trust my abilities, I can achieve not everything on this list, but a lot of it.
Yeah.
At least make it a lot better than it currently holds. And now to the part where I push back. She says here, let me see. Where is it? Jesus. She says here, after doing this exercise, read it to someone who loves you and get his or her reaction, which I did, and it was, you know, fine and everything. She says, start doing the things on the list, right? And one thing about this is there's a lot of things on this list that I can't do. There's a lot of things on Casey's list that she cannot do. And so I think there tends to be an issue with this, because if you're putting things on your list that you want to do and you can't do, then you're kind of setting yourself up for a failure that you don't need.
Mm-hmm.
I think that these lists should be re-examined often for things that are within your ability. Like with the house thing, I can't buy a house right now.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's an achievable thing later.
Yeah, but for us too, it's a later thing.
maybe what would be a good thing when you're, I think that these lists should be reassessed ever so often and amended and put in smaller steps.
Mm.
Like, do the first step that will lead you toward getting that house. And then, whenever you're looking at your list, you can check it off.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to wait until you get the house. And this way, you are reinforcing the fact that not only are you, one, doing your best to achieve a goal, but two, you're actually getting that endorphin feeling from having accomplished something.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yeah. So I think that if you're putting, a lot of people say reach for the stars, right? And they're well-meaning and all of that shit. But when you come from a family of people who just tore you down and abused you, and just you're really struggling in the first place to feel like you're anything but a failure, I think maybe reaching for the small things first would be more healthy.
Yeah, way more beneficial.
There are days when getting out of bed is like phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
It's a phenomenal achievement, right? So don't forget to celebrate the small stuff. I think maybe, you know, you can have your ultimate goals and stuff like that, but in the long run, if you're setting up a big list of things that, you know, like going to college, I can't go to college right now. Mm-hmm. I've got way too many responsibilities as a mom and a wife and things like that right now, and I'm not healthy enough to do so, and I cannot handle the stress of being a politician. Like, I know my limits.
Mm-hmm.
And if you are aware of your limits too, which you are because you're overly critical, but just realize that not all of those limits that you have in your head that come automatic from like the mom voice, the narcissistic mom voice, are truthful. So when you assess it, make sure that they're truthful, make sure that you're setting goals that you can achieve. And that's just kind of like, I don't know. I think that that would be more successful. It's kind of like when you go on a diet. A lot of diets fail because you're not allowing yourself to have a treat once in a while, right? So you're like, oh, I'm gonna quit, you know, because I already run my diet, so I might as well eat this whole tub of ice cream because I had, you know, 3 ounces of it already and I broke my diet. Mm-hmm. And that stops you in your tracks. And then you just totally give up. And that's not what we want to do. We're talking about changing a lifestyle in terms of the diet and in terms of recovery. It's a process, and every step forward should be celebrated, no matter how small it is. Mm-hmm. And if you're trying to leap, you're probably gonna, like, I don't know, twist your ankle. Okay, mm-hmm. So little at a time, y'all. Little at a time.
Definitely.
Anyway, long-winded. I'm done. Next.
So the next section is finding your interest in a memory exercise. It worries me when I ask women what they are interested in and they say they don't know. If this is the case for you, I want you to take some quiet time to think about what you liked to do as a small child. What kinds of things did you play with? Sometimes you can take a childhood activity and transfer it to an adult activity that fits your current interest beautifully. For example, when I did this, I remembered that before I turned 7, we lived in the country and rode Shetland ponies. I loved the horses and the countryside, but they also reminded me of country dancing and country music, and I threw myself into those two activities again. They are two of my favorite pastimes now. I also used to love to play paper dolls, which translates into a love of clothes and fashion today. Try this remembering exercise and see what you come up with.
Oh, this is good stuff.
Yeah, I mostly came up with just like the love of animals and wanting to do something with that.
Yeah.
And yeah, I'll get back to volunteering when I can, but that was just the main thing that kind of stood out. I guess coloring would be another activity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For me, like, I should engage in a lot of the activities that I enjoy more. But to be honest, like, I really love gaming, y'all. I didn't have gaming growing up, so being able to game right now is amazing. I really wanted a Nintendo, wasn't allowed one, so I'm just like really enjoying it, y'all. But when I was a kid, main things I did was play sports and dig in the dirt, and I really enjoyed reading and learning new things and being philosophical. I was a really weird kid. So, and also being creative, which I obviously still do, not as often as I should, but who says should anyway? Mm-hmm. I mean, who can gauge that? But yeah, digging in the dirt thing, I did start a garden some years back and I really enjoyed that. I tried doing it again here, but I have outside cats and, they saw me digging and just assumed it was a litter box.
Oh.
So, yeah, I've got to, and I'm sure everybody's going to have like a remedy for that and everything, but like recently we've had a drought, we've had all kinds of issues, and I just haven't felt up to it. So video games. Mm-hmm. With the love of philosophy, y'all know, right? Y'all know that I'm still like engaging in that endeavor.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, good stuff. And I really like this advice.
Mm-hmm.
Really love it.
She goes on to say, perhaps you are aware of what interests you have, but do not allow yourself the time to explore them or experience fun. To get in touch with the real you, you have to involve the child side of you to laugh and have a really good time. Don't deny this core part of you any longer. Find what it is for you. Allow yourself both leisure time enjoyment and what I call kick up your heels kind of fun. And then she kind of goes into examples for herself again.
Yeah.
And then, you were gonna say?
No, I was just gonna be like, yeah, I mean, why are we alive if not to enjoy a moment or two?
Right? Yeah.
Like, what would it be about then? Mm-hmm. You know, if you're searching for meaning, at least find it in that. Indulge yourself sometimes.
Yeah. Definitely.
Play a video game for a few months. Oh gosh. You want to go into the selfish?
Sure.
All right. So actually, let's talk about selfish. Many daughters in recovery have been taught by their narcissistic mothers that our patriarchal culture and our patriarchal culture, read much snarky, anyway, that focusing on their own needs is selfish. Women are the primary caretakers of others and are asked to be in giving mode at all times. And daughters of narcissistic mothers have also been treated as if they are not worthy of loving care. But remember, you can't give what you don't have. People who are fulfilled have an overflow of love and energy, and therefore can give freely of themselves to others without becoming exhausted. Their own tanks are full and charged, and they have energy to spare. If your spirit and energy are chronically depleted, if you are unhappy and unfulfilled, you will find it difficult to care for others. Thomas J. Leonard, personal coach and founder of Coach University. That sounds so funny.
It sounds fake.
It does. Said it best. Creativity and excellence require selfishness. So does evolution. Oh, don't get me started. All right. So when you know that you're onto something, a potential breakthrough of any kind, you need the purest kind of focus and concentration possible. You need to answer the callings of your heart and mind before you can answer the callings of the tribe. You need to accept that a reasonable and responsible level of selfishness builds long-term benefits for everyone you care about. And this is one thing that I want to go, because I love the stoicism, y'all. I love it. I would say that, you know, in stoic teaching, they talk about your duty as a citizen of the universe or the cosmos. And first, it begins with you. You have to do what's best for you. Because if you don't do what's best for you, then your secondary duty to your family and friends, or family, cannot be, you can't fulfill them.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't take care of yourself, and if you can't take care of your friends, it kind of goes out in these circles, in these layers, like an onion, you know, and you're the seed at the center of it. And if you're not there, if you are just deteriorating, the whole thing collapses. In order to be a good citizen of the cosmos, you have to take care of yourself, your family, your friends, your community, your country, your world. And this in this order. Because if not, then you're not going to be equipped to deal with anything, really.
Right.
It just falls apart. So, this is really good advice.
Very true.
The evolution thing made me cringe, but I mean, whatever. But yeah, any thoughts? That you want to share?
No, so I just think, like you said, it's good advice, and that's about it.
Cosmopolitan, baby. Ooh, I'd love to drink me one of those right now. That'd be nice.
I've never had one.
Ooh, girl, they're good.
Are they?
Yeah, if you like the fruity kind of, you know.
Yes, I do.
Pink drink, you know? all right, so physical health, which is very important if you're taking care of yourself, right?
Mm-hmm.
Though I'm not a medical doctor, this chapter would not be complete without mentioning the importance of your physical health, because some daughters are at risk for sabotaging themselves and engaging in self-destructive behaviors, I want you to accept fully that taking good care of your health is mandatory. Mandatory, okay? Sound mental health and recovery is not possible without your physical well-being. Now, I'm going to push back on, a little bit on this, because, you know, as most of our audience knows, you know, Casey and I both have disabling health issues, right? So, you know, we're not in the best of health, so to speak, but we are taking strides in order to be as healthy as possible. So as long as you are as healthy as you can possibly be in your situation right now, don't sweat it, right? Or sweat to the oldies, whatever you do, right? So yeah, it is important to take care of your body.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. I will list only general health areas to make sure that you include these in your recovery plan. If you're not attending to one or more entries in the list below, ask yourself why and figure out the barrier so you can overcome it. If you are having difficulty with something like an addiction, find an additional recovery program to enter so that you are getting the help you need. I compiled the following list after consulting with a family practice physician, James Gregory, MD. So yeah, and these are just, you know, general kind of stuff, like have a physical, you know, colonoscopy after 50, bone density tests after 60, eat a nutritious diet, drink water, exercise, get your teeth checked, sleep, like, you know, don't smoke, don't do drugs, don't overdo the drinking, etc. and so forth. Very, you know, straightforward kind of stuff that most people know. I'm sure Casey has the list up for yeah. y'all to kind of peruse in depth. But yeah, definitely in terms of recovery from addiction, y'all, this is a very tough topic on its own.
Mm-hmm.
And although I do have some experience with, you know, family members and even myself in terms of addiction, I used to take barbiturates a lot when I was younger and became dependent upon those. So that was really tough. It was a really tough time. And I'm glad to say I've been clean from that for well over a decade.
Yay.
So, yay! But this is the kind of self-destructive behaviors that one engages in when you're struggling with this trauma. So definitely seek help. Seek treatment if you're struggling with this, and even if you're not, right, if you're just struggling with the trauma alone, I definitely and always advise to seek a therapist.
Yes.
So yay. There went that talk.
The next section she's titled Talent Search, and she says the next area to assess is your talent. We are all born with some innate talent. It is your job to figure out what that talent is and pursue it if you desire. I have talked to many daughters of narcissistic mothers who are wildly talented in some area, but have never pursued their talent because they do not believe in themselves. Some daughters are very aware of their talents because their mothers pushed them like showbiz moms, but are now burned out and not using what they know and can do. Others were never encouraged. If you have a special gift and want to use it, pursue it, and try it again, do so. Work on grieving and healing any memories connected with your mother that are preventing you from following your talent, reconnecting with it, picking it up again. Life is short, and you were given certain aptitudes for a reason. You don't have to be a superstar. Whatever you do will be good enough. This exercise is not meant for anyone else. This is for you. One daughter I worked with, a talented artist, did not want to paint and sell or start her own gallery, but she did want to use her talent. She ended up volunteering in art classes at her neighborhood school and loved it. Another daughter had a beautiful singing voice and started singing in the church choir. You can be very creative with how you use your talents. Allow the full you to be in operation now. And for this one might be music for me. I do have the saxophones, So I can technically work on that. And we're in a place right now where, like, we don't share, we share walls, but they're at, like, the opposite ends of the apartment, so.
You play the saxophone?
Yeah.
Oh my fuck. That is so cool, I didn't know that.
Yeah, tenor and soprano.
Oh, you probably told me too, and I probably forgot.
I don't bring it up much, so.
Oh, wow, that's so cool. Like, I used to play guitar, I'm not really that good at it, but, this is my song.
You have a very pretty voice.
I like to sing, and you can tell everybody, this is your song. Maybe quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is. Now you're in the world. Okay.
Very pretty. Yay.
Yay, thanks. You're gonna get flagged for that if you don't cut it out,
probably. Yeah.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Maddie complains when I sing on streams. But this isn't Maddie's stream, so. And I've done it on other things, and nobody's ever had any issue. Anyway, I would love to hear you. No pressure, but I'd love to hear you play some.
Oh, it's been years. I feel like I would have to relearn everything.
It's like riding a bike. I mean, it might be a little rusty, you know, but once you get into it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But no pressure. I was first chair in regular band. I couldn't do jazz band in high school only because I didn't have, like, rides to the events and everything. But yeah. I did do jazz band because I was in FFA band. So we played at the state fair, and we did a jazz run for that, too. And I had a few solo moments. I can't do, like... what is it called? Improvisational. Mm-hmm. Like, I do really well with things that are already written. I never could do, like, the improv.
Well, shit, girl, I can't even read music. Like, that's amazing. Not everyone has a passion, but if you do, don't let this world go by with at least trying your hand at whatever brings you deep excitement and purpose. Explore things that stir your soul. She talks about her passion being dance and dabbling in it whenever she can. And she plans to explore every avenue of dance that she can after this book. And she hopes that for us too. She encourages us to sit with our journal and think about things that bring us our lives excitement. And what we're passionate about, whether it's something to help others or something socially significant. Or if you just like to collect things, read, you know, dance, sing, play saxophone, you know, do whatever you like. And hopefully by doing the exercises offered in this chapter, you're further along in answering the important questions we started with, which are, what do I value most? What makes me happy? What gives me the deepest sense of fulfillment? What are my passions and talents? So, what do you value most now that you're drinking your coffee? Coffee.
Yes, caffeine.
Right now, yes.
Yes, it's the only thing that keeps me mostly awake. Like, the core principles, like, the... very much in line with, like, the humanist principles, I think are basically the core of everything that I would value. You know, not causing undue harm to people, caring for animals, they deserve their rights and not to be treated like trash, caring for the rights of others, like, humans that don't have human rights is so wrong.
Yeah.
I just, like, I don't think people should be excluded for their race or their sexuality or their gender or anything to do with their identity. Like, I don't think that should matter. They're still humans.
Reach!
It's just so dumb that people think along those lines. Like you probably do, asshole.
Ooh. She telling it, y'all. She telling it.
But now, yeah, how about you?
I mean, all that, right? Definitely. I think that I would like to, you know, kind of leave the world better than how I found it, so to speak. Which kind of brings me back to how I found it, right? Which I found myself in a family of abusive, violent, drug addicted, drinking, asshole, racist pricks, right? Mm. And I'm not proud of it. And I think what I value the most in terms of my life and my values is to break that cycle. You know, I found out recently that I had an ancestor that was a slaveholder in Georgia. And I, you know, I was very disappointed, right? But was not surprised. Like, I came from a family of abhorrent races. And I hate it. But I can say that my values are antithetical to theirs, whatever, if you want to call their values, what their quote-unquote principles are based in fear and judgment and hatred and a selfishness that I just can't indulge in, because it does not take into account other people. So breaking the cycle as much as I can and speaking out whenever I see injustice. And like you said it all, really. I mean, that I can't top that.
Well, I don't
that was perfect. So what makes you happy?
My friends and family, the chosen friends and family that I have, my cat, my fiance, simple things, the little things in life.
Yeah, it is the simple stuff that really, really moves us, I think, the most. You know, there's a lot of people that are like, oh, if I just had a better couture, you know, like a fancy car or some shit. Like, I'm happy to just have a car that runs.
Right,
you know?
Yeah.
I appreciate, for one, myself. I make myself happy when I'm able to, when I actually trust my instincts on other people and, you know, what choices I should make. And I've made choices in a partner and in life and in friends that I can truly say that I'm now proud of, that I'm happy about. I'm content. Like, I laugh, I learn things, I'm challenged. I'm not just, you know, talking to myself about things that I enjoy without somebody even, like, not understanding, which in Texas that was a whole thing. How do you know all this stuff? You're so boring. You're such a nerd.
Oh my gosh. I've gotten that, like, I did not know that people not wanting to continue learning things was not a given. Like, I had a friend who was talking to me one time and was somehow, it got on the topic of, like, bugs in winter. And I was like, yeah, most of them go into this, like, hibernation state, and then at a certain temperature, they'll wake up. And I said, I'm always curious as to how many times they can do that, because, like, in our neck of the woods, the weather can be, like, 50 degrees one day and negative 20 the next, and then warm back up.
Yeah.
And she looked at me and she goes, how do you know this? And I'm like, well, I looked it up. Yeah, but why? Did you have to know it? I'm like, no, I just wanted to learn. And Greg's like, yeah, the whole wanting to continue learning is not a given. Like, that's actually a rare trait.
Oh my God.
It blew me away.
Yeah, it blows me away too. Like, I don't get how people can just completely ignore their natural curiosity about how the world functions and stuff. I've always thought that was a given too, but I lived in Texas and I don't see how I came to that conclusion, but I did. And I'm not even a very learned person. I'm just naturally curious about things, especially things to do with, you know, life and how miserable it is and how we may overcome it. So yeah, it's really difficult to find good people to talk to and people that have that actually give a damn and have humanistic principles. Mm-hmm. So it really is a rare thing. So as I said before, the trusting and my instincts has done me pretty well in that department lately. So I'm pretty happy about that. What gives you the deepest sense of fulfillment?
Helping others.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Video games. No, I'm kidding.
Hey, man. That works, too.
I love helping others. Like, it comes naturally. It's intuitive to me. But, like, in terms of my own selfish need for fulfillment, it comes from little stuff like, I'll be reading a book. And I'll discover something that I didn't know or I had always wondered about and couldn't find the answer to. And bingo, it's right there. And it just snaps. And it just, everything clicks and falls into place. Mm-hmm. I live for that shit. And what I really live for is having a partner that I can go, hey, baby, hey, check this out. And they're like, oh, yeah. Usually with this smug, well, I knew that. But sometimes with the, oh, that's fascinating, oh my God, and then it leads to a conversation. And that engagement and that sharing of ideas and knowledge is really, it gives me a kick. Mm-hmm. So there's that. All right. What are my passions and talents?
Passion.
Oh, come on now.
Passion
come on now.
For animals.
Yes, there it is.
That would be my, like, probably greatest passion. And talents, I mean, I can talk.
Oh, come on.
I think I'm okay at helping others.
Definitely.
And, yeah, so.
You were able to take the show On Our Last Nerve to whole new levels. I'm just going to say it. Like, we would talk about the most awful shit, and then you would just come in and be like, there's a dude that is stealing pool noodles. Dumping them.
Screwing them.
It was the life of the party, girl. Aww. That was the shit.
Oh, thank you.
You were able to bring joy into people's lives in a way that I don't think you really recognize yet.
No.
So, keep it up. Just keep it up and give yourself the credit. Recognize it when it happens.
Well, thank you.
Yeah. My passions. Oh, I have so many. Mm-hmm. I suppose my passion is trying to get to the bottom of things. Like the stuff that people don't normally think about, I guess. Obviously. Like, why are we here? What is my purpose? Yada, yada. And trying to figure out what my place is here and how I can make a difference in some way. Even if it's a small way, it would be worth it. So I don't know if that makes sense as a passion. And talents, well, hell. I'm great at making an ass of myself.
No, you're not. Hush. You can teach and like explain super deep philosophical ideas in a way that like even me, who's really bad at philosophy, can understand them.
You stop it.
It's hard though. Like it's really hard, and it's not a subject I'm really passionate about. So it takes like intense conversation for me to retain it.
Yeah, it's really difficult to get to find a passion in, you know, concepts like essences. Like I get that, you know. There's so many terms like like epistemology. Like who has a passion for that, you know? But it, nonetheless, when you get to, you know, what it is, and you know, we're talking about beliefs and how people come to conclusions and yada yada. It is actually interesting. But there's just so many like terms that people get stuck on. It's kind of like I would have been interested in the medical field at one point, but then I saw all the Latin and I went,
yeah, it's Latin and Greek.
Yeah, a lot of Latin, a lot of Greek, and you know what? A lot of the, especially the ancient philosophy. Guess what?
Latin and Greek.
Yep. So, yeah, and talents, like, I don't consider that a talent, really. I just consider it, like...
I do. I consider that a talent.
Like a passion, you know? I want people to be excited about things I'm excited about. It's really a selfish thing, I guess. But,
no! Stop it. I'm gonna come over there and kick your ass.
Oh, no!
Don't talk about my friend like that.
A visit from Casey? Oh, my God. How will I survive? No, I guess my talent is that. Mm-hmm. And I was really surprised when I was able to actually paint something. Because mm-hmm. I didn't think I could do it. And then it happened. So, there's that.
Yeah, so she finishes up. You have learned to strengthen your internal mother in order to build your self-confidence and to become more self-reliant. You now know how to deal with the collapse and get beyond these setbacks. I hope you are feeling more positive about yourself and can relate to Amy, who says, "My experience and my character are my gifts. I am a quirky chick now, but a very positive person. My life is my choice and I accept responsibility for my actions." My client Bonnie said, "I used to not be able to love myself. There was a dichotomy between what I knew and what I felt. I can feel that love for myself now, and I am a free woman, finally." You, too, gain these skills you need to build new internal strength. Now we move into the process of managing your relationship with your actual mother in a healthy new manner. Which, both Snarky and I, our mothers are long gone. But still, like, when I first read this, Mom was still alive, so, but I had gone no contact at that point.
Well, do you feel more positive about yourself?
I think so.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah?
Long road ahead, but definitely walked a good way so far, so there's no turning back now. Mm-hmm. I've invested too much time and effort at this point to give up. Definitely. And hopefully, you know, at this point, you know, the people that have been watching this series faithfully and, you know, any newcomers to the series, go back to the first one. Mm-hmm. First of all, if this is the first video that you are watching, go back to the beginning and go on this journey with us and see how you feel at this point, and you know, maybe do some of the exercises if you feel compelled. They actually do some good.
They do, yeah.
Do the work. You're worth the effort it takes to do the work. Mm-hmm. So hopefully, you know, y'all are feeling more positive about yourselves at this point as well.
Yes,
because it's not just about us. I mean, we're great, but
We just felt great.
It was so amazing. Oh, my God. I do that really too well. But yeah, it's hopefully, you know, it's reaching some other people and other people are gaining some positivity from this.
I think so.
Yeah. And if anything, reflecting upon the more positive aspects of themselves and that they can get beyond the trauma.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the recovery is what's crucial. If this is your first video, yes, go back to the beginning, back to the introduction. There's a lot of work that needs to be done before you get to this point. But yeah. And yeah, you better not be mean to yourself. Talking to you, Snarky, and the audience.
Oh, well. I'm so called out now.
But yeah, all the links for Mrs. Snarky's stuff are in the doobly-doo in the description. So check those out.
But yeah, plugging. Buy my art.
Yes.
Buy Trey's art too.
Yes.
As Trey is awesome.
Yes, Trey's.
If y'all awesome. Know Trey, like it would take me an hour to do an introduction on Trey, so to do any sort of justice. Trey did my avatar.
And mine.
And he's been doing some really good work lately. He's mm-hmm. got a comic out, something Innsmouth. It's H.P. Lovecraft.
Yes.
Story. And so yeah, they did a comic on that and it kicks butt and I would have brought it with me if I were a better friend so I could show it off. But I'll probably be in the chat giving links.
Yes.
Hopefully future Snarky, get on this shit.
And I'll put what links I can find in the description. Yeah.
Shadow over Innsmouth, I think it's called, because I'm just not with it today. Trey's gonna kill me. Anyways.
I'm not with it any time. Like, there isn't a time I'm with it.
Oh, come on now. But yeah, I mean, I'll plug that, and I already plugged Pine Snake's video.
Yes.
That I'm featured in, and subscribe to hashtag Heathen.
Yes, please.
And if you want to, yeah, click the like and the bell icon and, you know, all that good stuff.
Yeah, if you click the bell icon, YouTube might notify you when there's new videos.
If you're lucky. I mean,
if you're lucky, yeah.
It's more likely to inform you to give you a notification if you click it than not.
Yeah. So follow me on Twitter. That's the best place because I will post usually like a half an hour before, an hour before a video comes out. That's probably the most reliable way, because yeah, YouTube just decides at times to not tell you that people release videos.
yeah. And do me a favor, y'all. Give me some bunny emojis, because I love those.
Yes.
Lots of bunny emojis. Snarky.
Yes,
bun buns.
Bun buns for Snarky. But yeah, but remember, life can be shit, so let's get through it together. Keep hanging in there with hashtag and Mrs. Snarky.
Me!
Bye!
Bye! Mwah. Just check, 1, 2. Mic check, 1, 2. Gonna break it down. Got hashtag Heathen and Snarky in town. Yeah. What?
What?
Okay. Yeah.
Recording.
Had to.
Right?
Well, I didn't have to.
No, you did.
I wanted to.
Oh, man. All right. Hey,
all right. So, number 4 is something I could cough about. Sorry.
We're killing Miss Snarky.
Oh, I'm dead now. Okay. Me. Take 2. All right. So, number.
Yeah, I feel that. Oh!
Yay! Yay! And the time! timing couldn't be better. We got our ding dong.
We did get the ding dong. That's the first time in a very long time, too.
I know. It's like a sign or something.
Oh my lord. They haven't been ringing the bell either. Like, there was one day where it was freaking raining, and there were like 8 packages out there, and nobody had rung the doorbell. I'm like, rude. Thanks.
That is... I'd be kind of mad about that.
Mm-hmm.
Than kind of. Anyway! But... Yes! Two! We got two! I like to think it's because you play saxophone, and that's lucky. Just knowing that makes me happy. Oh my god. I think you did tell me at one point that you were, because we were talking about Little Snarky's musical endeavors and the trumpet, and how they were in jazz band and stuff like that last year. What was that?
I have no idea what that was. Oh, great. I just looked out and across the way, and there's somebody with a big old fucking Trump 2020 flag. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Oh. I was about to say the cosmos farted, but I think it vomited.
Yes. There's a little bit of vomit across the way. I don't know. I have no idea what that was. And we're, like, really far away from the main road, so...
Hmm. Yeah. Oh. Cosmos vomited. That's what it was.
Scared the cat.
Aw, poor Tomoko. Tomoko deserves better. You should get her another mustache. She's been traumatized.
She put it by her food dish now.
Oh, little eating buddy. I mean, she probably thinks that's her little baby, you know?
Probably.
Little bushy baby. I have a kitten. I'm proud of. Are you proud of me, Mama?
Yes, very proud.
I share my food with it. Oh gosh.
But yeah, definitely. If this is your first vehicle.
If this is your first vehicle.
This is your first vehicle, go back to the beginning.
Anti-lock brakes. And I tell you, the stereo system. We don't have the seat warmers, but we can give you an upgrade.
I don't know where that came from, but.
I thought, for a minute there, I thought you were trying to think of your outro.
No, that's up here. That's...
You got it?
That's good to go, yeah.
No sticky note yet?
No, but I think I need one for the clapper. Because when I do my gaming stuff, I have the videos being recorded on my laptop. And the game itself is being recorded on the computer. And so what I have to do is use this little clapper at the beginning. Oh. And that helps me sync the video, the two videos.
Ah, gotcha.
Well, I played a game. And it's called The Park, and that's going to be coming out. The first episode is Thursday of this week. So actually, the first episode would be last Thursday, if you're watching this on Monday.
We're back to the future,
yes.
Y'all.
Hi, future people. But I didn't remember to do that until 42 and a half minutes into the recording.
Oops.
So it took me an hour to sync all four episodes correctly. Oh. I was so mad.
Oh my god. Just like, that little thing. Wow. Yep.
Editing me was just like, no, this, you're a jerk.
Aww.
But, Casey. I need a post-it note to remember the clapper thing. But.
You need a post-it note to remember the post-it note to remember the clapper.
Yes. that's about it.
That's me as fuck. I can totally relate.
Right? I'm just like, oh, I should write this down. And then never do.
Yeah.
Ever.
Yeah. Yep. This is the way.
But yeah, outro. And any plugging you would like to do?
Well, aside from Maddie.
No, that's pegging.
Oh, well. I wouldn't call it that. It would be more of a plugging, trust me. Anyways, that probably shouldn't have been said.
I mean, I can cut it out if you want.
Do the little clapper.